Check it out, you guys.
It's Bulgari. So we're here in the Bulgari swing. We're in the Bulgari cigar lounge. Just going over with a friend, helping him with some content, content strategy, content planning, coming up with a few video ideas that we're going to shoot the rest of today. Just having a bit of a mastermind and sharing some insights around business and long-term strategy, that sort of thing. So yeah.
Just literally planning the
Yo,
all my L's they call me the V. Aye. Yo, she and I fuck my ex, got on sexy red in the V.
I'm on my sort of journey to make money and start businesses, and so being in a different place like London, you're surrounded by wealth. Most of the time there's wealth everywhere, but you're just not attuned to look at it. And so like we're seeing Rolls Royces, Ferraris, Porsches everywhere. I mean, you can probably hear one in the background. And just being around that, talking to people who are making money, networking with people with businesses, it all helps in terms of moulding your mindset, your attitudes, your frameworks, and your skill sets in order to become like them. Because the more time you spend around wealth, the more likely you are to become wealthy.
Get a good angle, bro. You're supposed to be a good cameraman.
So today is just a bit of a boring one following the trip to London yesterday. Currently going over the principles of how to build a really cool offer so that I've got those principles sort of ingrained into my head. So I'm just going over sort of building out a document right now in terms of exact step by steps to build a killer offer.
What book are you reading at the minute?
At the minute, I'm reading a couple of books because I've changed how I read books. So usually I used to read books how everyone reads books, and now I sort of pick and choose parts of books depending on when I need a certain type of information. So I sort of use books now as guides and like manuals. So like for this one, I'll just find an example now. I usually just go to the contents or the index and then say I need a certain part of information. I just go straight to that page and then study it and then sort of use it like that. So I sort of pick and choose the information I need. So I used to like read books how everyone reads books, but I'm able to retain a lot more information and, I don't know, sort of download the information better when I'm picking and choosing parts that I actually need, because a lot of books, there's a lot of fluff. There's like a story, and I just want to get to the bulk of the information. So a couple of years ago, I'd never read a full book in my life, like a proper book. And then once I started realizing how powerful the knowledge inside books were, that's when I sort of started reading every single day. But when I am reading, that's where you're sort of growing your information. You're downloading sort of insights from people who are doing the thing you want to do or have done the thing you want to do. I mean, Elon Musk was asked like how he qualified himself to be able to build SpaceX at the start, and he didn't have any qualifications from university or anything like that in physics or rocket engineering. He literally taught himself by simply reading books and networking with people who are in that industry. So like, if you want to get into an industry, if you want to learn about something, always start with books, because they're just like medians of knowledge.
Okay, so Thursday is definitely off the cards next week then, because we need to organise a call with Ben. Yeah,
so just heading down to the gym now,
to hit some back and biceps. I've been working out at home for a little while just because I've been really busy, so we get to get back to it. But yeah, meeting a friend down there, I'm going to hit back and buys, speak about business because he's running a cleaning company at the minute, so killing two birds with one stone. And yeah. So now we're at the end of the day, and I usually finish my day by doing this thing called a time box, where I basically plan tomorrow and write out the top three priorities after doing like a brain dump of everything I need to do. And then I've got like a column with the entire day mapped out, which I can organize everything so that I know exactly what I'm doing tomorrow, basically. Because it's always important to plan your day. I've probably been doing that for like 2 years now, and it just helps you crack on immediately, and it just helps being organised. If you can be organised in one thing consistently, then you have the building blocks to move on to something else that's harder. Most people are trying to do like achieve a huge goal and they can't even stay consistent at one simple thing for 100 days.